Like in the reality show Bachelorette, the beautiful girl can pick the man of her dreams from a full lineup of eligible bachelors. However, there is an end to the line no matter how many bachelors are waiting. In 1572, the 40-year-old queen found one suitor left, 18-year-old Francis, Duke of Antrim. Hercule Francois was the youngest son of Henry II of France and Catherine de Medici. Since Henry III of France had no heir at the time, he was heir to the throne of France. As you can see in this picture, he was actually quite good looking. So good looking that I almost mistook him for another French leader who broke all the rules to marry his wife 24 years his senior. Just like the current French president Emmanuel Macron, the Duke of Anjou was quite rebellious. Although quite a Catholic, he did not get along with his brother King Henry III and joined the Protestant rebels. His cousin, Prince of Condé and King of Navarre. This forced his brother Henry to sign the Edict of Bouillon in 1576 without a fight. In 1579, when 24-year-old Duke of Anjou came to court with 45-year-old Queen Elizabeth, the two became very close. But the romance was not welcomed by the English people, who considered his Catholic faith a threat to England. But in 1578 and 1581, the Duke of Anjou became the protector to the Huguenots and a potential leader of the Dutch. English's Virgin Queen was close to losing her virginity to this French charm half her age. When Walsingham was sent to France in mid-1581 to discuss an Anglo-French alliance, it was almost a done deal. But the French wanted the marriage agreed first. While the English were under instruction to obtain a treaty before committing to the marriage. As the deal fell apart, the rest is history. On Anjou's 1581 farewell, Queen Elizabeth penned a poem on Monsieur's departure. Unless she wrote the poem with the intention to fool us all, she seemed to really love the young prince. When the broken-hearted Anjou suffered another defeat in Antwerp, Queen Elizabeth officially ended their engagement. Duke of Anjou returned back to Paris and died in 1584. When the Queen heard of his death, she cried publicly for 3 whole weeks and wore black for 6 months. To the French ambassador, she described herself as, quote, a widow woman who has lost her husband. So the Virgin Queen was not a virgin by choice, but by circumstances. But there must be a reason why she let so many great marriage proposals go. It is a mystery best to remain unsolved.